all the prophets. This is what they say. Behold, a virgin shall bring forth a son, and his name shall be called Emmanuel, meaning God is with us.
For unto us a child is born, for unto us a son shall be given, his name shall be Wonderful Counselor, the Prince of Peace, there shall be no end to his kingdom.
The prophets foretell a wonderful Savior. Yes, a baby who will grow to lead us in God's ways and reconcile us to God himself. He will be with us forever. He will never leave us nor forsake us. Now, when God was ready to give Jesus to the world, he chose a good and pure woman named Mary to be his mother. Mary lived in the little village of Nazareth and was engaged to be married to Joseph, a humble carpenter who lived nearby. One day, when Mary was alone, God sent his messenger, the angel Gabriel, to appear before her.
Hail Mary, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women.
Mary was at first frightened and confused by this reading of the angel of God. Then the Gabriel told her that God had chosen her to give birth to Jesus.
Fear not, Mary, for God has chosen you to have his son. You shall call him Jesus, and he shall be called the Son of God, and his kingdom shall have no end.
Mary now understood everything she had been told, and it filled her with great joy and happiness. She replied to Gabriel, saying,
May it be done to me as the Lord wills.
Not long after she had spoken to Mary, the angel Gabriel appeared to Joseph one night as he slept. In Joseph's dreams, the angel of the Lord told him God's plan.
Joseph, God has chosen you to have a son, and Mary will be your mother. Do not be afraid to take her as your wife.
When Joseph awoke, he went to Mary with great joy in his heart. Both Mary and Joseph had heard that God's son was coming, and they were overjoyed to be chosen of God to be his parents. And so, Mary and Joseph invested in the quiet lives, keeping God's secret and making him themselves. Now, at that time, the land in which they lived was ruled by the Romans. The Romans were mighty but wicked rulers of an enormous empire. The chief ruler, a man named Caesar Augustus, was mean and greedy. He wanted to tax everyone in the land to raise money for himself and the Romans, so he issued a decree.
I'm sorry, I've never known my end.
cows, camels, and sheep, even the dove and the goose in the shelter of the stable. The Mary and Joseph were grateful for any shelter they could get that night in the little town of Bethlehem. That night, when Mary gave birth, the animals were very pleasant, for the birth of Jesus.
Thank you.
Just as before men became more rough and more political, the nuns transfigured me out of cold and loneliness. Said that night that Jesus was born, the angels gave him suddenly appeared above them in the sky. Men like his came brighter than the edge. The shepherds had never seen an angel, and they were frightened, but the angel of God soon comforted them, saying,
"Fear not, good shepherds, for I have wonderful news. Today, in the city of Bethlehem, a child was born. This child shall grow up to be our king, and not just any king, but the king of all kings, the Messiah, the Savior of our world."
"Please, tell us where we can find him."
"You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothing in a manger."
Then suddenly a multitude of heavenly angels appeared in the sky, and they announced the news to be Jesus. Glory to the newborn King. He shall bring peace and goodwill to all mankind.
Yes, that's it.
Let's follow it.
Finally came to the three wise men, or magi, shining star in the sky, until it stood on the little stable in Bethlehem for the holy infant day.
Thank you.